Venue, the racecourse ground, 4th Division Wrexham, the cup team of the year so far, against 1st Division West Ham, the winners away to Oxford or Sunderland. Commentary from Tony Gubba.
How long can the fairy tale last? You can feel the expectation in the air at the racecourse ground after those two sensational cup results against Arsenal and West Ham. But for Wrexham's new kids on the block, the problem tonight will be how they cope with being favourite. Well, manager Brian Flynn sticks with the same 11 from the two previous FA Cup ties, so teenager Lee Jones, who came on as a substitute to equalise against West Ham, stays on the bench. West Ham have two changes from the side which drew 2-2 with Wrexham. Ludo Miklosko is still out injured, and so he's replaced by Tony Parks for the second game in succession, while up front number 10 Mike Small is preferred to Trevor Morley as the striking partner for Frank McAvenny. Colin Trussell of Liverpool is again in charge as Wrexham in the red shirts start this match attacking the goal to the left. Can they collect a second Division 1 scalp to add to that of Arsenal, which already hangs on their belt? There's got to be a result tonight, extra time and then penalties if required. Inside by Davis, went under the foot of Phillips. It's McAvenny looking for his new partner up front, Small, and trying to squeeze it out down the left, and it was easily dealt with by Thackeray. Connolly kept it in play. Watkin looking for Gordon Davis. That was a trip as Phillips tried to burst through. Steve Potts the offender, and Wrexham have pushed a lot forward. Mickey Thomas will take it. Oh, it's there, is it? Watkin got a foot on it and then he didn't quite, and it might have broken to Gordon Davis as well. Just running his fingers through his hair, he knows how close that was to a real good chance. Lovely flick on by Carey, and finally Foster back to Parks. So Torrey got highest. This is Keane. Brown, Keane again. Mitchell Thomas. Keane. And Sartori did a good job of shepherding both the ball and McAvenny. Kenny Brown's header. Oh, Carey left it. They wasn't sure. There was a bit of indecision then between himself and Sartori. This is Hardy. Ever present this season, this 18-year-old, who's attracted a lot of admiring comments from bigger clubs. And that's a great ball to find Connolly, who stepped over Breaker, and he's kept it in play. Did he? Oh, not quite. The flag went up. The header was from Owen, the save was from Parks. It wouldn't have counted. It had just run out of play. But that was a really bright bit of football. Crowd of around 18,000 showing their appreciation. A terrific ball played out by Phil Hardy, first of all. Well, it was a touch-and-go decision. The linesman put his flag up. Oh, well, that was a terrible ball by West Ham. And that's a great one to find Watkin. He's on his own. There's very little support. He's got it right across the face of goal. It was a terrific ball by Watkin. Dix who cleared. Well, if there'd been more support further upfield, quicker for Steve Watkin, then West Ham might have had problems. He did well to get that round Foster. Corner. Mickey Thomas, he loves to hit them with that left foot as they drop. Owen, tried to take it in his stride and get past McAvenny at the same time and lost it. Only 20 years of age, Welsh under 21 international, and began as an apprentice here at Wrexham. Well, West Ham have come into this match and beaten in their last five games, 1-3, drawn 2. And well, the decision was given by that linesman in Wrexham's favour, and Mike Small looked very puzzled. The linesman was as close as he could possibly be. Satori wants Small back even further. McAvenny. This is Brown. It was kept in play. Thackeray will have to do something. In fact, the linesman's given the corner, yes, it wasn't quite going to run. And Slater got there very quickly. Ball came off the defender. So, just under 20 minutes gone, West Ham's first corner. Foster up. And it was from corners that Wrexham didn't defend too well in that first match, but they did all right there. Davis. Oh, Watkin will have to come back, he's offside. Oh, he's pushed it right through them. It's a terrific break, and he's kept his balance. That was a trip. That was a trip. Now, if the letter of the law is applied, that trip on Connolly will see Tim Breaker sent off. What will Mr. Trussell do? Connolly had outstripped him. There's a posse of players round there. But what else can he do, the referee? Breaker, remember, who was outstripped by Lee Jones for the equaliser. And looking at that replay once or twice, it may be that Breaker thought about trying to catch his heels, but to his credit, he didn't in the first match. But he took down Connolly then. And maybe it's a yellow card. Well, that's one to look at and debate. Breaker stays on. Wrexham have a free kick. And Mickey Thomas has had his say to the referee as well, just by the ball. Now he'll take the free kick, Mickey Thomas. But that's a controversial talking point. Chipped up beautifully, they're all forward. Oh, nearly, Owen. Well, it was a well-worked move. This is one from the training ground, a little chip up. Gareth Owen had continued his run, and he swung a leg at it and missed. Nice flick on by Small. Here's McAvenny, West Ham's first chance, and O'Keefe has made a very good stop. Well, that'll do the 34-year-old a world of good. That's one for building confidence. Hardy. Owen. Breaker. Carey's jump, it's dropped for McAvenny, and now Slater. Oh, well done, Stuart Slater. He let Thackeray dive in. Dix on the outside. And who was it covering? Gareth Owen. Small. Dix. Oh, it was a trip, but he kept his feet, Slater. And Mickey Thomas concedes the corner. Well, have Wrexham been practising their defence from corners after the two they conceded at Upton Park? One from Dix, one from Morley, one in each half. Both came from corners. That's Foster! And he's there, the big man. Colin Foster, tallest figure in that penalty area, has put West Ham ahead. Against the run of play, it has to be said, after 27 minutes. And yet again, Wrexham have conceded a goal from a corner. Well, there was no defender jumping with him, it was only O'Keefe the keeper. It looped in over the top of Thackeray, and yet again Wrexham have gone behind in an FA Cup tie. Hardy. Connolly. Hardy again, he'll get to this. Watkins inside. We might have checked back because he was a little bit offside. Still Hardy. Well struck, right footed. We didn't really ask too much of Tony Parks. And when he first got into the team, Phil Hardy, he actually replaced Alan Kennedy, the former Liverpool player, who was allowed to go because Hardy looks such a good prospect. Wrexham have won it back. Well, that looked like a foul. Wasn't a lot of doubt, surely, Mr. Dix. Well, two-footed from here, anyway. Five minutes to go to half-time. Mickey Thomas with the free kick. Wrexham still looking for a way back. Foster's headers only down to Connolly. Carey! Oh, he took it well, Brian Carey. It was a half chance that broke to him, but he got a lot of meat into it. First shot across the face of goal was by Carl Connolly. And when it ricochets out to Brian Carey, he struck it well. That's West Ham's throw. Breaker. This is time added on to the first half for stoppages. And there haven't been too many. Hardy. This is Potts. Keane, Potts again. Phillips, who took it away from him. Phillips still. There's nobody that way. Well, all the help was the other way. Slater for West Ham. Mitchell Thomas. Smalls jockeying for position. And O'Keefe kept his eye on it. Dix. Satori. Oh, he's only succeeded in giving it to McAvenny. And has to concede the throw. Keane. Back to Slater. As the whistle goes to end the first half, which is disappointing from Wrexham's point of view because they had the better of the chances in the first 25 minutes, but it was Colin Foster who put West Ham ahead somewhat against the run of play with that header from the corner after 27, and since then a little of the Welsh fire has died and it will need to be rekindled in the dressing room at half time. Here at the racecourse ground, it's Wrexham 0, West Ham 1. West Ham haven't reached the fifth round of the FA Cup yet. Remember, Wrexham were trailing in both the games against Arsenal and in the first match at Upton Park and scored all their goals in the second. And Tony Parks might yet have a busy 45 minutes. Connolly, back to Hardy, forced to hurry by Small, who handled, and free kick, which has already been taken. Connolly, Mickey Thomas, Gordon Davis. Well, if Wrexham make a start to the second half, anything like the one they made to the first, then this game could quickly be turned around. Here's Watkins, he's taken it off Dix. Oh, Dix recovered well. just for a minute. Dix was in trouble, but he did really well, the number three. And Slater to put McAvenny away. Nobody in the middle to look for. And he's tripped from behind by Carey. Free kick. Well, the one thing Wrexham don't want to do, of course, is concede a second goal. But Watkin was so quick to take that off Dix, who then, in response, did well himself. Brown, back to Keane. Foster stayed forward. Slater. It was a diving tackle by Thackeray. Foster's coming in. Header out was by Carey. This is Phillips. Not what he intended, I'm sure. Well, Wrexham have won all their home FA Cup ties. They're going to have to come from behind again if they're to do the same to West Ham that they did to Arsenal. Mitchell Thomas forcing the corner. He's there again! Oh, well, unless they pick him up and unless they deal with him from corners, Wrexham are not going to find a way back. He got to that and just directed it wide. Hardy. Again. Gordon Davis to chase. And he's got it. Well done, Gordon Davis. This is Thackeray. This is Owen. Oh, it was drilled across. Now, was he looking for a head? Was he looking at the target? He's really pumped up and down this field, Gareth Owen. Attacker 1 minute, defender the next, and he thumped that right across goal. Watkin was brought down from behind by Potts, free kick. And Potts is being called across, and that may be one tackle too many. He looks a bit confused, and I have to say that Steve Potts hasn't been a particular offender tonight. In fact, that's Ken Brown that he's talking to now. And Ken Brown is indeed cautioned. Too high for Watkin. Joey Jones shouting encouragement. So Trevor Morley on and Mike Small off. And you'd have to say that the decision to play Mike Small from the start hasn't really been a great success for West Ham. Oh, might this fall? Owen! He did everything right and it needed a fine stop from Parks. And that's what Wrexham want. They just want one half chance like that. And Wrexham are preparing to make a substitution themselves. And it's the goal-scoring hero from the first match, 18-year-old Lee Jones, who comes on to replace number 7, Gordon Davis. And he's got 17 minutes to make an impact this time. Well, he only had 13 in the first match. Dix. Morley. Phillips. Back to Thackeray. To Watkin, who took it down very well. Now, this is the boy, Lee Jones. Faced by Potts. Left foot cross. Header out only as far as Hardy. Mickey Thomas left it. Conley! He's got it across goal, and it was behind three of them. What a pity. And that was a good opportunity. It was a neat bit of football. They really had the pressure on. But when that ball came across, it was right on the penalty spot, and the three red shirts had been sucked in closer. Flick on has found Lee Jones. who was fouled by Potts now. Well, the ball had been played a long time before the tackle went in. And for that, Steve Potts now does get his name taken. Wrexham have got 8 in and around West Ham's penalty area. That was Carey, it's still there. And Connolly's header, goal kick. Well, if Wrexham had the rub of the dice and the luck of the green in the match against Arsenal, you feel they're not quite getting it here tonight. If Tim Brakel had gone for what looked like a blatant professional foul on Carl Connolly, West Ham would have had to play for the lion's share of the match with only 10 men. It's certain to be one of the talking points. Into the third minute of stoppage time, and relief will surely light up the face of Billy Bonds. Nicky Thomas, that came off the defender. Wrexham's throw, and Mr. Trussell is being as good as his word. He's added quite a lot of time. Connolly, Nicky Thomas. Oh, the header was by Watkin, and it went behind for a goal kick. Well, Wrexham have given us some new names to think about. Steve Watkin is one of them. He's only 20 years of age. Phil Hardy, the left back's another, as the whistle goes and the dream is snuffed out by a goal from Colin Foster, scored after 27 minutes, and Billy Bonds will be mightily relieved that West Ham have gone through. No disputing the credit for Foster's goal, he took it really well from the corner. But should West Ham have been down to 10 men before that? Well, their supporters won't think so, but one or two neutral observers may. It's goodbye to Wrexham, beaten here at home in this fourth round replay by West Ham by a goal to nil, but certainly not disgraced, and deserving every bit of this applause that they're getting from a massive crowd here in North Wales.
Well, they go out, but they've delighted us with some quality football this season in the Cup.
They were brilliant tonight. They were brilliant. Unlike the famous victory against Arsenal and the first game against West Ham, tonight they took the game to their opponents. They were the better side. In the first 25 minutes, they created about 3 or 4 chances. Mm-hmm. And they kept that up throughout the game. West Ham were hanging on. There's no doubt about that. And as you say, this whatever else happens in this season's FA Cup, Wrexham will be the side that will be
so far. And mm-hmm. They've got some quality young players too, haven't they?
Yeah, they're certainly going to have chances of moving up from that lowly fourth division position.
Hope so. Well, one incident in that match may have changed the course of the game. Let's hear first what the managers thought.
It's a pity in a way there has to be a controversial talking point from what was a very enjoyable match, but the referee's decision only to caution Tim Brakel when a lot of people felt that he might have gone.
I don't criticise referees when we've had decisions go against us, but I thought it was a sensible thing to do tonight. I didn't think it was malicious. We've suffered from those things in the past, and I didn't think...
You did in the FA Cup semi-final.
We've suffered before. I didn't criticise the referee then. And really, I've got to applaud him for taking the sensible view.
Nobody wants to see a professional sent off, but if you apply the letter of the law, then it has to be consistent, and he should have gone.
Yeah, I understand that, but I don't think even Brian would have wanted to see a professional goal for that. I don't think it was that.
Brian?
No, I agree entirely with Billy. I mean, if you look at the second goal when we scored at Upton Park, Tim Brakel could have easily done that to Lee Jones as well, and he could have gone, and he didn't. I mean, it was one of them sort of things. Carl made the break from the halfway line. Exactly the same as Billy. I don't want to see a professional player sent off in circumstances like that.
Just a thought about the goal that you conceded, because it was another one from a corner. You conceded 2 at Upton Park from corners, and the goal that put you out was another corner.
That's right. We have been working quite hard on corners. Well, defensively, I thought we caught fairly well. He is a problem, Colin Foster, from corners because of his size. I don't apportion any blame to any particular player, but good luck to West Ham. They, you know, I do hope they go to all the way to the cup final.
I'll tell you what, you put the name of Wrexham on the map, though, haven't you?
Yes, I mean, it's been everything. It's been exciting. The romance of the cup has been, you know, we've hit the headlines. We now have to get back down to earth, look towards the Welsh Cup, and look to try to get up the league now as quickly as possible.
And can West Ham make something of this now, Billy, do you think? Can you go on and have a good cup run?
We've started a little mini revival now. We've had a couple of good league results, which is important to us, well, more important than the cup to us, really. But, you know, I think the two go together. We were fighting promotion and we got to the semi-final last year. This year we're fighting relegation and a good cup run won't harm us, so hopefully we can go on a little bit further.
Thanks very much, anyway. Great cup tie.
Thank you, Tony.
It was good. The managers were diplomatic there about that breaker challenge. What did you think, Bob?
Well, he should have gone. That's fairly definite. But I think he should, Des, really. And to be fair to referee Colin Trussell, he said it's the most difficult decision in his career. And he said that he wasn't 100% convinced that it was a goal-scoring opportunity because there were other players around. But you'll see, Carl Connolly, he's away, he's clear, there's nobody around him. That is a clear goal-scoring opportunity. And although he's still got to put it in, compare it to the semi-final last year when poor Tony Gale is sent off by Keith Hackett against Gary Crosby, who was in fact running away from goal, not even at goal.
Less of a scorer.
But here it is again. You'll see that he is clear. It is, without doubt, a goal-scoring opportunity. It brings him down. And I would say 75% of referees would have sent him off. But, of course, we have the hindsight of the old cameras again here. He might really have consulted his linesman. They're supposed to be a team.
What is the law there? Because you've got it there, haven't you? I mean, because some of our viewers might not
well,
quite
it says
understand.
Quite clearly, if in the opinion of the referee, a player who's moving towards his opponent's goal, as we saw Carl Connolly doing, with an obvious opportunity to score a goal, which he had, is intentionally impeded. You can sometimes hide behind that. Impeded by an opponent through unlawful means.
Must have been intentional,
though, mustn't
it?
Yes, he booked him. Yeah. He booked him. Thus denying the attacking player's team the aforesaid goal-scoring opportunity, the offender should be sent from the field of play. Yeah. Very tricky.
Tricky one, but we reckon Tim was lucky.
But he's fair. He said it was the most difficult one, and I might have got it wrong,
okay,
to be fair to